The gross execution time is calculated from the start to the termination of a task. Therefore, it is influenced by all interferences with this task except the start delay. In this example, you can see that the gross execution times is calculated from the start here until the termination of this task, and all preemptions shown in this light green color are accounted into the gross execution time. The only thing that is not considered here is the start delay from the activation until the start of this task. If you want to set up such a requirement in the Timing Architect tool suite, you can first of all go into the requirements menu of the base part of this tool, and you will find this overview where you can first of all select for which task, in this case the 1 millisecond task, you want to create the requirement. In the metrics, you can search for the gross execution time and select this metric, and at the limit type, you have the possibility to select between the upper and the lower limit. In this case, we want to set the upper limit for the gross execution time of the task 1 millisecond, and we will select 3 different severity levels that will be checked against the simulation or against the scheduling trace that you have recorded from your hardware. In the Timing Architect tool suite, you can now see the Gantt chart of your system. You can see on which core which runnables were running, when they were activated, when they started to run, and you can also see when they are preempted. Below, you can find the process table, which currently displays the gross execution time minimum, average, and maximum for the task 1 millisecond. We move now to the requirements table. And in this requirements table, you can now find the 3 requirements that we have defined for the gross execution time of the task 1 millisecond with 3 different severity levels, critical, major, and minor requirements with the limit of 0.7, 0.6, and 0.5 milliseconds. You can here see that only the minor severity criteria has been violated in total 109 times in this measurement. If you now drag and drop this requirement into the Gantt chart, you can see with the red arrow every time when the task 1 millisecond violated this minor gross execution time requirement. If you want to find out where these violations happened and what was the maximum violation of the gross execution time, you can use the histogram that is provided by the TA tool suite, and you can simply drag and drop this requirement also into this histogram. What you can now see is the distribution of the gross execution time for the 1 millisecond task, and you can see that it is distributed between the average value and the minimum and the maximum value that we have already seen here in the process table. In the histogram, you can additionally see here the deadline that we have defined for this minor violation at 0.5 milliseconds. And you can see everything on the left fulfilled this requirement, and all instances here on the right have violated the requirement. If you want to analyze the requirements violations in more detail, you can, for example, select the outliers in this case. You can right-click, send them to the clipboard, and now here on the right side in the clipboard, you can see all instances that have been violating this requirement. If you now click on one of these instances, you will always jump directly to the point in the Gantt chart where this violation happened. So in this case, we can see here that we had the requirements violation of the gross execution time. And you can switch to the different occurrences of this violation. At the end of this video, I want to offer you some possibilities to stay in touch and find out more about timing analysis. For that, I'm inviting you to join the LinkedIn group Runtime Analysis in AutoSAR Projects. In this group, you will meet other people working in this field, sharing their experiences and solutions for this topic. And you will, of course, also be able to engage in discussions and ask your questions there. Just search for the group directly on LinkedIn. Or if you want to have it easier, I put a QR code here in the video so you can simply scan the QR code and you will be redirected to this group. Would be happy to have you in the group. If you have questions to me directly or if you want to connect with me, I'm inviting you to scan the QR code here on the right. You can also see the link to my profile here on LinkedIn. I would be very happy to connect with you and answer any questions you have. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm looking forward to stay in touch with you.